please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Well, so you're speaking in terms of cures that the rupee depreciation should help, but we should try and do more for the export sector and keep a very sharp eye out on macros like fiscal deficit. But what about needing instruments like interest rate hike, which we had to resort to in 2013, or even something like the special NRI bond, the FCNRB scheme? Will it come to that?
Well, I think those are always weapons you have in the armory. But I think it's important, and this is one place where we've made a very important move since the last crisis. It's very important that the RBI continue to signal, as it has done so far, its concerns about keeping inflation on track, about raising interest rates whenever appropriate to fulfill its inflation objective. That gives investors confidence that the rupee is not going to go into free fall, because ultimately inflation will be under control and the rupee can get significantly undervalued if it continues falling at these rates.
So basically stick to good macros as the Reserve Bank has been doing. Raghu, let me get your views on the global economy as well. Are there any red flags? I mean, the emerging market currencies, some of them are wobbly, including the rupee, to some extent, much lesser than the others. But should we worry about the global ambience as well? After all, there are tariff wars, trade wars, and they don't seem to be ending anytime soon. Can these conflagrate into a crisis?
Well, I think we have two big sources of vulnerability that have built up. One, of course, is the leverage that has built up across the globe, not just in flows to emerging markets, but also within industrial countries. There are sectors that have become very highly levered. For example, in the U.S., the shale industry is highly levered. In certain other countries, Australia, the housing sector is highly levered. So pockets of leverage have built up across the world, just as they had before the global financial crisis. So that's the source of one source of vulnerability. The second important source of vulnerability is policy. As you just pointed out, trade, there are big questions over it. That tends to dampen cross-border investment, but it also creates an adverse effect on sentiment. Couple these together, and what you have going forward is the possibility that suddenly, when a country is vulnerable, you have an additional political shock which comes from the trade side. That's a volatile mix. Now, on top of all this, we have interest rates rising. The employment numbers that came out on Friday for the United States suggest that U.S. growth is strong and inflation is picking up, which means the Federal Reserve will continue raising interest rates over the next few quarters. So if you put this mix together, it is basically suggesting that times are going to get tighter going forward, especially for highly leveraged entities. And we'll come to know where those problems are as we go forward.